This is Juan Alvarez Street. This is the street where the students, the normalistas, were stopped by municipal police. The initial shooting occurred on this street as three of the buses were coming up this way to get to this main avenue. And this is where the shootings occurred.
The police ambush in Iguala, where six people were killed and 43 students were disappeared, understandably shocked Mexico. But if police officers carried out the attack, then someone likely ordered them to do it. José Luis Abarca became mayor of Iguala in 2012. On September 26, the day of the attack, his wife, María de Los Ángeles Pineda, was scheduled to hold a political event meant to bolster her chances to succeed her husband as mayor in 2015. According to accounts by federal investigators, Abarca ordered the police to stop the Ayotzinapa students from potentially disrupting his wife's event. As he and Pineda danced with Iguala residents just a few blocks away, municipal police were opening fire on the buses. The mayor's wife, prosecutors later said, had family links to a local drug gang called Guerreros Unidos, or United Warriors. Guerreros Unidos had split from the larger Beltrán Leyva cartel and is involved in marijuana and poppy production in Guerrero. Federal officials called the mayor's wife the chief operator of the cartel inside Iguala City Hall, allegedly funneling money from the gang to the police. On September 30th, 4 days after the police attacks, José Luis Abarca requested a leave of absence, and soon after, he and his wife vanished. Since the students disappeared, volunteer search parties began scouting the hillsides around Iguala in search for any sign of them. These volunteers belong to a community police force that emerged in recent years in the state and is known by its Spanish acronym, UPOEG. They told us the authorities were useless in the search for the missing students and that they would not stop until they found the students themselves.
Nuestro operativo consiste en la búsqueda de los jóvenes desaparecidos, asesinados, en lugares donde no ha ido el ejército ni la marina. Ya vimos que la gente más confianza nos tiene, que hemos venido aquí sin armas, sin idea de estarnos enfrentando con el gobierno. No, nosotros venimos nada más en plan de búsqueda de estos jóvenes desaparecidos.
A few days later, the first of the mass graves around Iguala was found. We went to check out one of these graves with a group of UPOEG volunteer searchers.
This area is called Pueblo Viejo. Up behind me, this hill right here and that one is where the first of the mass graves that may be linked to the case of these missing 43 students is located. And locals basically know this area and these hills behind me as a clandestine cemetery. These hillsides, according to the state police officer, is basically the territory of at least four different criminal groups that operate here in Guerrero. One of them, of course, would be Los Guerreros Unidos. I can only imagine the fear and the terror that any victim might have felt walking up here on this march of death to a grave where they were placed and buried along with dozens of other people. So this is what it has come to in the state of Guerrero. Here you have civilians, a community police force, volunteers without weapons, conducting their own search for possible victims of the Iguala police attack.
Nosotros somos pueblo. No somos policía de la policía de esto que usted conoce. O sea, puede confiar en nosotros, ¿por qué? Porque nosotros somos del pueblo y somos para el pueblo.
We're sitting here waiting for human rights workers to come up here and verify and begin documenting the discovery of this other grave that may or may not be related to the case of the missing Normalista students. But in any case, reflects what has been said before, that Mexico itself has become a clandestine grave. And while these men are up here volunteering and searching for victims on their own, Mexico's government is essentially playing catch up to the work of volunteers, as we're seeing today.
Creo que es una fosa que encontramos aquí. Y le estamos excavando, vimos que estaba ancho. A lo mejor hay alguien ahí enterrado.
¿No?
Another thing that we've noticed along this pathway leading up to the grave is really an abundance of forensic trash, garbage. So you can see here, biohazardous waste. I'm not a forensics expert, but I would say that this is probably not the best way to get rid of this waste here in this investigation scene.
Obviamente hay una falta de profesionalismo, principalmente las autoridades de aquí de Guerrero en el tema de la identificación. Hay búsquedas inadecuadas, el proceso de exhumación, el proceso de identificación ha sido caótico, ha sido todo un problema. Los estudiantes y los padres de familia han propuesto ellos un equipo externo, que es el equipo argentino de antropología forense, para que coadyuve en la investigación.
The Argentine Forensic Anthropology Team has been invited to massacre investigations in El Salvador, Congo, Bosnia, Colombia, and many other countries. Parents said they would trust no one else. Back with the volunteer search parties, we witnessed firsthand some of the challenges they faced working in the hillsides around Iguala.
El compañero Diego recibió una llamada telefónica donde lo estaban amenazando y le dijo que él tenía la orden de matar toda la gente inocente y que nosotros nos largáramos porque si no íbamos nos iba a cargar la verga.
Apparently, we are being watched by someone else. So it just kind of gets to the question of who's really in charge here.
Al parecer, según es el dueño de la, el encargado de la plaza de aquí, yo ni lo conozco, no sé, pero así lo mienten ahí en el teléfono.
Los tres niveles de gobierno le han perdido la confianza porque no han cumplido. Han dejado un vacío a la gente en un abandono a los pueblos. Aquí es una impunidad y la mayoría de los políticos en su campaña política han sido financiados. Estaban involucrados con la delincuencia y fueron financiados. ¿Y cómo le van a hacer para defender a la ciudadanía? Tiene una cuenta pendiente. Ahora nos dimos cuenta que la solución de los problemas, la solución de la corrupción, la solución de la delincuencia está en manos del pueblo.
We returned to the Ayotzinapa campus to meet parents and relatives of the missing as the days ticked on without any sign of the 43 normalistas. There we met Felipe de la Cruz Sandoval, a graduate of the Ayotzinapa school and a parent of one of the surviving students.
Para nosotros, el gobierno estatal y el municipal, pues representan la máscara del crimen, de la crueldad. Aquí en el estado no es nuevo que el gobierno esté infiltrado o el narco esté infiltrado con el gobierno. Posiblemente no hayan cometido el error que cometieron hoy en matar y desaparecer a estudiantes, porque hoy sabemos que es un delito perpetrado por el estado, porque fueron policías los que se los llevaron.
On October 11th, as more mass graves were being discovered around Iguala, Ángel Aguirre, the governor of Guerrero, announced that none of the 28 human remains so far found in the known pits belonged to any of the missing students.
Sí, les puedo afirmar que algunos de los cuerpos que, de acuerdo con los avances que se llevan de los peritajes en materia forense, no corresponden a los jóvenes de Ayotzinapa.
Protesters, meanwhile, clamored for Aguirre's resignation, blaming him for the lack of governability and rule of law in their state. On October 22nd, Ayotzinapa students and parents marched on Iguala in their first return to the scene of the crimes. After the students and parents had left, other masked individuals looted and torched Iguala City Hall. It was unclear who these other guys were, but local residents and journalists speculated that they might have been sent by the Guerreros Unidos drug gang, or even sent by the government to discredit the otherwise peaceful demonstration.
¿Alguien me puede decir a dónde vamos y para qué?
La Comisión Mexicana hacer un desmadre.
This group moved over to a mall linked to the mayor of Iguala and also ransacked it. After about an hour of this looting, federal police finally arrived. But by then, people had run off with flat-screen TVs and cell phones.
Yo soy uno de policía.
Sí, chico.
Yo soy policía.
On October 23rd, Governor Aguirre responded, stepping down, he said, to allow the investigation to continue freely.
Para favorecer un clima político que ponga la atención y la solución de estas prioridades, el día de hoy he decidido solicitar licencia al Honorable Congreso del Estado.
Gobernador, ¿no va a hacer una declaración sobre los alcaldes que están involucrados en la delincuencia?
La verdad, estamos muy enojados, porque ellos quieren cerrar el caso ya con entregarnos o eso, que ya nuestros hijos están muertos. Y nosotros estamos considerando que ellos están vivos.
So far, all of the search efforts had focused on finding the remains of possibly murdered students. But the parents were adamant that the efforts should focus on finding their sons alive.
No nos vamos a quedar, nuestros hijos tienen que aparecer. Porque ellos están vivos, pues, y los tienen. Nosotros sabemos que están vivos y los tienen. ¿Por qué no los quieren dar?
More frustrated than ever, on October 29th, the parents of the missing students traveled back to Mexico City to meet with President Enrique Peña Nieto at Los Pinos, the presidential palace. The press wasn't allowed inside of the meeting, but one of the parents shot this footage on a phone.
Estamos aquí con la intención de decirle a usted que le ponemos un plazo no mayor de 2 o 3 días para saber resultados concretos. No están en las cosas. Y eso quiere decirnos a nosotros que nuestros muchachos están vivos. La agonía es larga. Si usted ve ya el enojo de cada uno de los padres, la desesperación, no creo que a partir de ese día usted también pueda dormir tranquilo. Creo yo que si usted no tiene la capacidad para darnos la respuesta ya, también debes de estar pensando lo mismo que el gobernador de Guerrero.
Pues definitivamente los padres de familia, pues con tanto dolor, con tanto coraje, pues lo tomaron como era, ¿no? Otro discurso más de un funcionario que no ha hecho nada, que la ineptitud se refleja en el momento de que a más de 34 días desde la desaparición de los muchachos sigan con la misma respuesta de que no los pueden encontrar.
The parents refused to leave Los Pinos until Peña Nieto signed a document promising the government would search for the students alive and not as human remains. The parents, exhausted, angry, returned to Ayotzinapa and decided to gather for another march, demanding their missing are returned.
Queremos decirles a todos ustedes, al pueblo de Guerrero, a nuestro país y al mundo entero, que no vamos a descansar hasta que tengan que aparecer los 43 normalistas.
On November 4th, the ex-Iguala mayor and his wife were apprehended in a rundown house in Iztapalapa, Mexico City. The arrest may have brought the authorities closer to solving the case, but for the Ayotzinapa students and the parents of the missing, their struggle was just beginning.
Federal officials said that in this lot behind this rusted fence, there is apparently another mass grave. Authorities were led here based on the testimony of 4 suspected members of the Guerreros Unidos cartel. These 4 individuals would be, theoretically, under this line of investigation, the last men who saw these 43 missing students.